I welcome you all to the another part wherein now we would go ahead and see something else, you know, in the descriptive statistics using Python. Now, you see, in the earlier video, I had, you know, retrieved described function for my data frame that was created by the CSV file that was uploaded on the Colab. Now you will see that rather than getting the entire rows or columns for the CSV file data that I have uploaded, now you know sometimes it happens that I just need one particular row or column. Okay, now at that time, what will I do is I have to go ahead and somehow, you know, include or call or include only the specific number or the object or the string that I require it. In other sense, let's say this thing that the describe function gives us mean, std, and count, maximum, minimum, 25%, 75%, all this kind of a data. Now, I'm not looking for that, all those kind of data. I want a function which you know tells me more about the character columns and gives me the summary about the numeric columns. Okay, now this can be taken care of using another function or the argument, we would say, not the function, I'm sorry, called as include. So I would say that I would use or present include argument in the function in such a manner so that it helps me to retrieve the information specific to the columns that are necessary in summarizing my data. In other words, it is the argument now using the technical language which is being used to pass necessary information regarding what columns need to be considered for the summarizing part of my data. Now, this takes, you know, various ways in which I can use. For example, I can summarize the entire column using object, or I can even use what I call it as number, which summarizes my numeric columns. Sometimes I need both, you know, I need string as well as numeric column. So in that case, I would be using all as my value. So the default one that takes the values is the number, which gives us the numeric values. So first and foremost, in this particular video, I'm going to showcase to you as to what would be the coding if I have to summarize only the string columns of my data. So here we go. And you can see that, yes, I have already got, and now I'm going to use the my coding in such a manner that, you know, I would be able to do it. Now, as usual, why did I halt? Because I wanted the new code area to be present, and there here I have copied the coding. The coding, how does it go? Print. Now, as simple as that, I don't have to write anything else. Print is the one reason I want the complete result directly. Otherwise, I can simply write df2.describe and then carry forward to get the result. However, I'm asking the software to give me the print so that you know, I get the result. I can simply copy and paste into for my results form in the analysis of my research paper. So here the coding goes: print, simple brackets open, df2, which is the data frame which I have created, dot describe. Now you see very carefully, I have opened the brackets. I have I'm calling include as the argument, and this is equal to what? In single quotes, object. Now what is object? Object is used specifically for the string columns to be retrieved, and I have closed the two brackets. One for I have used the bracket. I have opened the bracket before the word include, so I have to close that one, and for immediately the bracket that was opened after print word, so that also have to be closed. And now you will see I will run the entire code and we will see what would be the result for my this thing. And here you can find it that, yes, once I run the code, I would be getting the results as title, type. Now one has to be very careful in reading this one. Title is what? Title is the column that they are reading. Okay, type is what the kind of a type it is. How many rows are there? How many columns are there? What kind of type they have taken it. So here count, they are saying the total number of rows that I have got is 5837 and the type is numeric, which is 5837 again. Unique one they have showcased is only two, which is the one that I have got, show ID and the release underscore year is the one that I have got. Then topmost they have given to you that yes, these are the one tunnel one and movie name that they have taken care of. Now similarly you can see that yes, the entire thing is coming, the result is very very different from the other softwares that I have seen, giving me the information with respect to exclusively the rows that I'm looking forward for. Then you have seen I have got, it is giving me the top, that is the heading, rather than heading they're just simply saying top line says tunnel one and movie name, and then they have even used the last one as to be frequency is 3 and the total number of types in it is 3030. So here they have given you that there are 4 rows and so many columns also. Now this is the result. Now you see, this is the fun in using and understanding more. I mean, I never learned descriptive statistics in this way, using a software, you know, and especially understanding the intricacies of these things also about my own data. So I have gone ahead and I thought, okay, let me share this thing with all of you also. Till then, thanks and take care. Bye.